Number seven, I have to admit I made this mistake myself because it happens so many times when you are sending out the resumes so many companies to so many people and they call you back after a month or after 3 weeks and you completely forgot for what job you have applied for what role you have applied for what company you applied for and what was the reason you applied for. You forgot. So I got a phone call that I am scheduled for an interview, and I ask for what position, and they told me a manager position. They told me I applied for a teaching position, but then they based on my credential that they saw on the resume, they would like to interview me for a manager position. Now that was the secretary who told me about this. Now after we are doing a phone call for an interview. At the scheduled time, I've been interviewed not for the manager position, I've been interviewed for the teaching position. So all my answers were about leadership. So there was nothing about teaching. So that was kind of like a turnoff because the hiring manager was kind of like, didn't understand what am I talking about? What am I interviewed for? And then she's like, okay. So we'll be in touch. And at the end, I'm asking, what was the role that I'm actually interviewed for? And she said for a teaching position. So it's completely made me look stupid. So next time, if you are in the same situation like me, you are supposed to keep a log, a resume log that I've created, a resume log that I've created for you to actually track down who you sent the resume to, what date, who are the hiring managers. So sometimes there is a name to it. And then you are able to also do a follow-up email, follow-up call. You have the name of the company, Google it up. Call the company and find out the hiring manager's extension. Now let's say you do have the log. Let's say you do have everything else. And now you receive a phone call, but the log is not in front of you. What do you do in this case? In this case, you say, I would love to speak with you, but at the moment, I'm in the middle of something. Can we schedule a time to speak about the role? And then you schedule a time, and then you are going to look at your log and find the name of the company, find the name of the role, find the name of the job description, and then get yourself ready. This shows you're very professional. Sometimes we're urged to say, oh yes, I would like to schedule an interview. Oh yes, like it gives you an impression that you are gonna get hired on the spot. But you should say, I'm in the middle of something. Can we just schedule a call? Another way of saying it is, I'm really interested. But as I recall, I have been applying for several times. Can you just remind me for which role is this? And they can just tell you. But that sounds very professional saying this. I applied so many times for so many jobs. Can you just remind me for which role it is? Which company is this? So that's it for today. Give me a like if you like this video and you have learned so much from my video. Let me know in the comments what is the question that you have been asking at the interview and then you regret it. You regret that you asked it. Let me know in the comments. I would love to read it. Subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends, and I'll see you on the next video.